Welcome back. We are still looking at construction of clients. Just to get accumulated debt and money, give you that phone so that you get these lessons. You are not missing anything, and I know you never cannot set outside the syllabus. So this is what we are supposed to be learning. Thank you very much for being very good children at home and sitting to learn. Today, we are going to look at, in our lesson 7, we are going to look at how to construct a triangle still, but this time, when we are given two sides, in the previous lesson, we are given three sides. This time, we are given us two sides and one angle. Two sides, one angle. What happens? We have an example here. Construct a triangle PQR in which angle PQR. Now, this is where we make a lot of mistakes. Angle PQR. The angle PQR is found here at point Q. We are going to see that when we are making our sum. Angle PQR is 60 degrees, line segment PQ is 6 centimeters, and line segment QR is 7 centimeters. That's the triangle we are going to construct. Are you ready with your pair of compasses and the pencil and the ruler? Yes. So, we are going to it's not going to be different from what we learned in the previous lesson. Someone's going to ask me, but teacher, what about if I don't make a sketch? Please make a sketch. It earns me money. Then another person asks, teacher, what about if I don't make a summary? Please make that summary. It helps you to come up with a correct sketch. So, summary. This summary, we are getting it from this information. Construct a triangle, PQR. So the name of the triangle is PQR, in which angle, they are looking at the angle. So angle, the symbol for angle is that PQR is 60 degrees. Line PQ, line segment PQ is 6 centimeters, and line segment QR is 7 centimeters. They are given us the angle. The angle is at Q. The angle, the letter in the middle here tells us where that angle is supposed to be. That angle here, the 60 degree angle, is at point Q. After we have made our summary, we are going to write the sketch. To draw the sketch. Making our sketch. Now, this is different. In the previous lesson, we had a choice. We would begin with any side to be our base here. This is not that, it's not the case now. Yes? For this particular question, where we have an angle given, that angle should either be here at that bracket or there, not up. Reason is, if we put it up there, it's going to be difficult for us to construct it. So, the angle is either that vertex or that one. What does that mean, therefore? That my Q, because the angle must be at Q, the angle must be at Q. The letter in the middle. So, my Q will be put there. And when I put Q there, immediately I put there 60 degrees on my sketch. So now the other letters will come. PQ. PQ. I can put R here. When I put R there, ask yourself. When you put your R there, ask yourself, do we know the distance from Q to R? Q, R. Yes. Then you smile. QR is 7 centimeters. Now that means, yeah, that name in brackets is P. So, what are we left with? We have not put 6 centimeters on our sketch. 6 centimeters is line P, Q. P, Q. Don't make a mistake and write it on the side that is not PQ. That's why the summary is important. PQ, 6 centimeters. Sketch down. Please make the summary carefully after reading the information that is given. Then make a correct sketch. Don't just draw and fill in. Anyhow, no. The arm must be either there. If this 60 had been put here, then which letter would you put here? Q. You put the letter Q and R come inside. So we are done with the R sketch. Now we are continuing to the accurate diagram. Two sides given and an angle. So accurate figure. Steps taken. We are now getting from this. I want you tomorrow to be constructor. Wowing, build for us houses, which are very nice. So first step, we draw the baseline. Always start with the baseline. Baseline, mark a point. That point that I have marked, which is this one, is point Q. That is point Q. Take a measurement of 7 centimeters, because the distance from Q to R is 7 centimeters. Take the measurement of 7 centimeters. I told you that for my case I will double. So 7 centimeters from 0, you stretch your compass, your pair of compasses to 7. And now double it to 14 so that you can view clear. Have you done that? Good. Then center at that point Q and draw an arc to cut that line. That is done. Name that point R and indicate 7 centimeters. Let me tell you something. What you have just done there, much as you have not completed the construction of the triangle, you have a mark. You have a mark. That's how sweet mathematics can be. You have a mark. And not only one, you must even have another one for the sketch. I mean, one, two, but you have not answered the question fully. So we have done that. Then the other thing is, at Q, we have an angle of 60 degrees as per our sketch. So construct an angle of 60 degrees. We learn how to construct 60 degrees. This time we are constructing it on our right, because that is where our triangle is going to be. So we are constructing the angle of 60 degrees, that arc, center there without changing the radius of the compass, and draw another arc to cut the first arc. The angle of 60 degrees is that. Join. So after carefully joining, indicates that this angle that I have constructed here is 60 degrees. You have another map. So what next? Now we need to get point P, which is along this line. We need to get point P, which is along that line. Okay? But we know that point P is 6 centimeters away from Q. That means we are going to take a measurement again of 6 centimeters. 6 centimeters. From zero, that's where my compass pointer is, to 6. I hope you have done that. Put it at 6. Then center the compass there and draw and cut this line like that. Don't repeat. I've repeated because mine was not clear. The other one is clear. See. So this is point P, where the arc cuts the line is point P, and then the distance from Q to P is 6 centimeters. And the triangle is done. So now the final thing is to join. We are joining this point to that point to complete the construction of our triangle. Is there anything missing? Go back to your sketch and check. Do I have the points? Yes. Do I have the angle? There? Yes. Do I have the 6 centimeters? Yes. Do I have the 7 centimeters? Yes. My construction is done. Then the other question can now come. They will be ask you the additional question. Part B, measure. They always like asking such questions. Measure Roman 1, angle Q, R, P. And Roman 2, line R, P. A line is measured in centimeters. An angle, we measure the growth factor, and the answer must be degrees. And I told you that the angle QRP is found at R, meaning that this examiner wants you to measure this angle that are between lines QR and RP. Protractor is the one you have to use there. So that you don't miss any mark in case they ask us. Remember, we say the center of the protractor is placed at the vertex where the angle is found, and that black line is the base. On my protractor, there is no black line, but any part of the protractor is my base line. For you, for your protractor, there is a black line running through. So you center your protractor there, like that, sitting on that line, and read this side of the protractor, because that's where the triangle is. When you read this end, then you are reading outside the triangle. So we are reading that side of the protractor, that side. And you must start reading from zero. You see the zero? Yes. So follow that scale. There are two scales, but I'm using the outer scale because my zero, which is lying on this line, is on the outer scale. 0, 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 40, 45, 50, and it is less than 60, 55, 56. So my angle is 56 degrees. Now, if you have measured yours and you're not, you don't have 56, don't say you are wrong. No. There are many factors here that can make you be wrong. One is the thickness of the chalk that I'm using here. So don't panic and say, mine is wrong, it has 156 are up. But what you have there, what you need to know is that, have I constructed the right thing? So the measurement depends on the correctness of what you have constructed there. Then for the line, you use the pair of dividers that I don't have here. The pair of dividers is that instrument in the set which has a pin in this way and a pin in this set. So that you stretch it from R to T like that. And then from there, you take to the ruler. Take to your ruler. According to mine, I'm getting 6.5 centimeters. You have constructed a triangle where an angle has been given and two sides have been given. When I come back in the next lesson, we are going to learn what about if you have given us two angles and only one side. Thank you very much. Please continue revising. Actually, we don't have time. Continue doing a lot of revision where you need these angles constructed. I'm only giving you one example there, but you can have many because angles, we have constructed many angles here. So you can even set your own question, changing the angles. 45 or 30, and so on. Thank you very much for being here. Very nice class.